So let's talk about keloids. Keloids are a thicker scar than we would like it to be. So anytime you have any trauma to the body, so if you get your ear pierced, you know, if you're shaving, and if you're doing a surgery, right, we're cutting through the skin. So it's creating a little trauma for the body. The body tries to heal that, right? And it throws collagen at that to heal that with scar. If that scar is thicker than we like it to be, but it's still in line with the scar, that's called a hypertrophic scar. If it starts getting beyond what our initial incision was, that's a keloid. And who are more likely to develop keloids? Well, those are genetically gonna be people with darker skin color like myself. So Indians, African-Americans, Hispanics, people from the Middle East, just darker skin tends to create a little bit more genetic, more collagen. So it can be darker scars and a little bit more prone to keloids as well. They can happen in Caucasian patients as well, but they're a little bit more rare because genetically they're just not as prone to that. So what would we do? Well, keloid scars, if it starts to get a little thick in there, we'd still work on the aggressive scar massage and topical scar cream like vitamin E. Topical scar strips tend to help that as well. The scar is going to continue to change 12 to 18 months, so it'll keep improving over time. But then we can also put some Keloids injections into that. That's a steroid injection. Generally, we'll try to limit that for people because they do have some side effects sometimes. They can cause some lightening of the skin, hypopigmentation. They can also cause some thinning of the skin as well. So the surrounding tissue can get a little thinner than we'd like it to be. So we try to limit that to more extreme cases if we can avoid it for certain people. But we are gonna try to create the scar as pretty as we can. It's always closed the same way for every single patient. It's just some patients are more likely to develop those type of keloid scars, especially in high tension areas. So things like a tummy tuck, things like a breast lift, we are tightening up the skin more dramatically, so there's more tension. So a little bit more pulling can sometimes create a little bit more of a keloid or thicker scar. But that's how we would treat it. That's how we would do it. Thankfully, it doesn't happen to most patients, but there are some patients that'll just develop it and they're just kind of unlucky enough to have that happen. We'll try to get those modalities to help treat it, to help soften it, and hopefully minimize that for you for the long time.